realize this, but the Illinois Governor's Sustainability Award is the longest-running environmental award in the country. Dr. Thomas did mention that at one time when it was created, it was maybe one of two in the country. And over the years, there's been several others that have popped up, but they have not had the longevity as of this award. Whoops. You and I don't know how to go the right way. Again, I would like to have everyone join me in congratulating our two founders of the awards who happen to be here together again today, Dr. Gary Miller and Dr. David Thomas. So thank you very much. And I'll just give you a few statistics about the award. Over the years, since 1987, we have given or granted the award or honored 287 organizations across 147 cities here in Illinois. This year, we will honor 15 first-time award recipients, 12 continuous improvement, and we're giving honorable mention to 14 organizations across the state. And as Eric mentioned, we will be also honoring the Campus Sustainability Compact schools that have achieved that next level of their commitment to sustainability. So at this time, a few kind of housekeeping issues. We will be taking photos as the awards are announced. There will be a photo opportunity for additional photos after the awards presentation. We'll suggest because it's up in the front area, it seems to have the most space. We do have boxes for the glass trophies in the back. Please, as you leave after the awards ceremony, take any box that you like. There may be names on it, but don't worry about that. The boxes are all the same. Presenting the Governor's Award today will be Dr. David Thomas and Eric Heineman. And then presenting the Campus Compact Award will be Dr. Gary Miller from the Prairie Research Institute and Eric Heineman. So if I could ask for Dr. Thomas and Eric to join us up at the front, and then invite John Mulrow up to the podium, who will be announcing each of the awards as in the alphabetical order.
So yeah, I think the way it's gonna work is you come around this side and get the trophy, certificate, shake hands, get a photo, and move on to the next. We're gonna, we've got, I think it's something like 50, 51 groups coming across. So we're gonna try and move it along and hold applause till the end of each group. We'll do a round of applause at the end of each group. And while I have the microphone, I just wanted to clarify, I didn't quite suggest we substitute Bug Burgers, but I did call, I called every Oaxacan restaurant in the Chicago area I could find and confirmed that there are 3 restaurants that serve fried grasshoppers as an appetizer. They weren't in season, so I couldn't pick any up and bring them down. So just so you know, Eric's not crazy. There are restaurants that serve that right here in Illinois. Okay, so with that, we will kick it off. So our first Governor's Sustainability Award winner is AbbVie, and we have Dan Dellert and Eileen Openbrier from Lake County Operations to accept the award. Okay, next we have the Aptar Cary campus, and John Washabaugh and George Murata are here to accept the award for Aptar. I feel like we could handle a quick round of applause in between each one while the photos are up. Yeah. This is more active that way. Okay, from Caterpillar, we have Randy Peterson, Advanced Technology Development Manager, and Ken Gray, Global Product Manager, here to accept the award. There we go. Next, from the Champaign-Urbana Mass Transit District, we have Bill Volk, the Managing Director, and Adam Shanks, the Illinois Terminal Director, here to accept the award. Congratulations. I was definitely worried about getting like fingerprints on these things when I was checking them out earlier, so it is a balancing act. Okay, next, from Chem Processing, okay, there you guys are. We have Andrew Jarrett, EHS Director, and Paul Foster, Wastewater Treatment Operator, here to accept the award. Congrats. And next from the City of Joliet, there you guys are. We have Kendall Jackson, City of Joliet Director of Planning, and Margaret McEvely. Sorry about that, Margaret. I called her to get her name right. I just screwed it up. Margaret McEvely, City of Joliet Purchasing and Contracts Administrator, here to accept the award. Congrats. Okay, and next from ComEd, we have Marla Westerhold, Environmental Compliance Specialist, and Sharon Pluskis, Director of Environmental Health and Safety, and Tim Bolton, here to accept the award. Congrats, guys. Next, from Eaton's Cooper B line, we have Chris Dietrich, Regional EHS Manager, and Alex Jett, Regional EHS Intern. Congrats. And I just want to mention that you can read more about what each company has done in the program. I really wish we had time to mention a couple sentences about all the awesome things that and across a huge spectrum of environmental performance indicators that people have done, but we're just focusing on getting the awards and photographs done. So definitely check out your programs and read on the details. We tried to put as much quantitative information in there as possible. So next from the Elmhurst Park District, we have Daniel Payne and Annie Schiappelli. Sorry. I really tried to go around and get that pronunciation right ahead of time. Next, from Forest Preserve District of DuPage County, we have, wasn't going to have a problem with these names, I think, Michael Webster, Manager of Fleet Services, and Christopher Lyon, Assistant to the Manager of Fleet Services. Congrats, guys. Next, from Hilton, Chicago, we have John Wells, the General Manager, and Courtney Davis, Assistant Director of Events. Congratulations. And J.L. Clark is next. From J.L. Clark is Doug Patton, Plant Superintendent, and John Guthrie, Plastics Plant Manager. Congratulations. And from our neighbor educational institution in Champaign, Jefferson Middle School. We have Jeff Freimuth and Jennifer White, both science teachers at Jefferson Middle School. Oh, I jumped the gun, sorry guys. And here's the science teachers over here. Congratulations. And from the Label Printers LP, we have George Tomasi, Director of Human Resources, and Gina Reese, Quality Assurance Supervisor, and Don Tesh. Don Tesh here to accept the award. Congratulations. And from Lewis and Clark Community College, Nate Keener, their Director of Sustainability. Congratulations. I guess in the year 2100, he's going to be the sustainability of sustainability, because that'll be every word we're using, right? And next, from McDonald's Corporation, actually representing McDonald's, we have Ed Sagan, Manager of Property Management, and Cindy Fitzgerald, Manager of WSC, that's Workplace Services?
Workplace Solutions Center.
Workplace Solutions Center at McDonald's. And then Dave Bernotis, Building Operations Manager with Jones Lang LaSalle, and
Barbara Merlin.
Congratulations, guys.
No bugs in the hamburgers this week.
This week? Okay, we got no bugs this week. There's still next week. Speaking of bugs, the next group coming up is from the Metropolitan Mayor's Caucus, and they are the Illinois Emerald Ash Borer Wood Utilization Team. So they're using the wood part of the Emerald Ash Borer work. And we have Edith Macra, Director of Environmental Initiatives, and Warren Goach, Bureau Chief of Bureau Environmental Programs at Illinois Department of Agriculture, and Tom Dilley, Natural Resources Specialist with the U.S. Forest Service. Congratulations. Okay, I'm going to need something other than bug jokes from now on. So let me know if you got any ideas. Next is multi-film packaging. And we have Ida Manertorp here to accept the award. Ida is the account manager and sustainability coordinator at Multifilm Packaging. Congratulations. So next we have Niles Township High School District 219, who worked with their consultant Beyond Green Partners. And we have three folks coming up to accept the award. We have Jeffrey Greenspan from the Board of Education at Niles Township, John Heinz, Assistant Superintendent, and then it's
Greg Christian
from Beyond Green Partners. And I just wanted to quickly mention, related to Eric's presentation, Beyond Green Partners was Illinois' first B Corporation. So congratulations, guys. Okay, next we have from Quaker Foods North America facility in Bridgeview, Curtis Zicker, engineering manager, and Angela Giotto, health, safety, and environmental supervisor. Congratulations. Next, from Quaker Foods North America, Quaker Oats. Well, it says Quaker Oats Company, but you guys do a lot more than that. Quaker Foods North America, Danville facility, Andy Lampera, principal engineer, and Mason Floyd, maintenance resource. Congratulations. Next, from University of Illinois, Chicago. Oh, sorry. Let's see. Yeah. Well, I know your guys' names because it sat next to you, but I do have the sheet here too. From United Airlines. Sorry, guys, it was out of order. Greg Kozak, Senior Manager of Environmental Strategy and Sustainability, and Meg Witte, Senior Staff Representative for Sustainability. Congratulations. And next, it's University of Illinois at Chicago. And I believe it's specifically the Office of Sustainability at University of Illinois at Chicago that's winning the award. And here representing, we have Vitenis Milunis, Director of Project Management for Physical Plant Administration, and Kate Yoshida, Program Coordinator for the Office of Sustainability. Congratulations. For recognizing specifically facilities management at University of Illinois Chicago. Thanks. Okay. From the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign, we have Stephanie Loggi, Assistant Director for the Center for a Sustainable Environment, Morgan Johnston, Sustainability Coordinator at Facilities and Services, and we also have Tracy Osby here. Tracy, can you tell me your title? Just so everyone knows, Tracy's the Campus Coordinator for Waste Management, which is near and dear to my heart, having set up your compost stations today, which I'm going to check later for contamination and put together statistics. Next is Village of Arlington Heights. We have Thomas Glasgow, Village Trustee, and Stephen J. Mullaney, Public Works Service Coordinator. Congratulations. Next, from the Village of Bolingbrook, we have Tony Torres, Director of Operations for Public Works and Engineering, accepting the award on behalf of the Village. Congratulations. Okay, and from the Village of Downers Grove, Nan Newland and David Rao. Nan is the Director of Public Works, and David is Public Works Management Intern. Congratulations, guys. Okay, we're gonna recognize our honorable mentions next. First is Argonne National Laboratory, who wasn't able to send anyone. So we wanna recognize them for being an honorable mention. And we are lucky to have CCI Manufacturing here, who I also sat with. Shout out to Table 6. We have Milena Strama, QA Specialist, and Dan Aloya, Vice President for Business Administration at CCI. Congratulations. Next, Christopher B. Burke Engineering and City of Evanston. We're not able to send anyone here today, but we want to recognize them. Christopher B. Burke has their pretty cool bike program on the cover of the program, one of the pictures we featured there. And next up, we have Clark. And representing Clark is Julie Reeder, Vice President for Human Resources and Sustainable Development, and Karen Larson.
Vice President for?
Karen's the Vice President for Regulatory Affairs. Congratulations. And next, we're recognizing Clover Technologies Group, and we have Renna Brunton, Marketing Specialist, and Adelaide Rivero, Legal Intern. Congratulations, guys. Next, we're recognizing the Ecology Action Center, and we have Michael Brown to accept the award on behalf of the center. Congratulations. Next is the First Busey Corporation, and we have Don Schlorf, Executive Vice President of Corporate Administration and Director of Sustainability at the bank. Congratulations. And next is the Illinois Department of Military Affairs. And we have Jonathan Casebeer, the chief from the Chief Environmental Branch of the department, here to accept the award. Congratulations. From the Illinois Department of Transportation, we have Steve Massey, Manager of Sustainable Practices at the department. Congratulations. And cool news about the bike lane, protected bike lane. From the Illinois Green Business Association, Cassandra Carroll, Executive Director, here to accept the award. Congrats. And lastly, We would like to recognize Lawrence Foods, Portapure LLC, and Will County for being honorable mentions. These three groups were not able to send anyone today. And I think with that, could we have a big round of applause for all the governor's sustainability awards? And we're going to have Gary Miller from the Prairie Research Institute here to present the awards along with Eric. This next round is the Campus Sustainability Compact Awards Program. We're reading off the names. And these groups achieve different levels, which I think, Eric, were you able to explain the bronze, silver, gold levels? And then again, the descriptions of the criteria and the accomplishments of the universities are also in your program. So without further ado, from Danville Area Community College, we have Dr. Alice Marie Jacobs, president, Dr. Andrew Cairns, regional coordinator for iGen Career Pathways, and thanks, Bruce. Bruce Raitt, Dean of Business and Technology at the college. Congratulations. Okay, next from Heartland Community College, we have Catherine Dunlap, Associate Director of the Green Economy Initiative at Heartland. Congratulations. Next from Lewis University, we have Don Costello, Associate Vice President for Facilities, and Jackie Boyle, Facilities Coordinator for Sustainability and Administration. Congratulations, Lewis University. Next, from McHenry County College, we have Kim Hankins, the Director of Sustainability. Congratulations. All right, and representing Northwestern University. We want to recognize Northwestern University as an award winner. They weren't able to send anyone. So there's probably not a better fitting end than the Prairie State College for the awards program. And we have Alessandra Cairo, the sustainability coordinator at Prairie State, to accept the award. Congratulations. And lastly, we have from Roosevelt University, Tom Shelton, Physical Resources Coordinator, and Professor Mike Bryce. That's right. Thanks, Professor. Last winner of the day, big round of applause. Thanks, guys. Congratulations. Okay, so one final round of applause for all our award winners, accomplishments, speakers.
Let's give a round of applause for our announcer. I think John did a great job, so thank you.